The following program is a production of WXEL Television.
Coming up next on WXEL TV, everything you need to know to survive a hurricane. From your home, to your garden, to your kitchen, we have all the tips. This is South Florida Today. I'm Tony May. Welcome to our show. As you know, we are in the midst of hurricane season, and that means you and your family should have a plan, have made a kit, and know where to turn should a hurricane approach. Well, joining me now is Steve Bear from the Red Cross. And last time you were with us, you gave us great tips on doing those things. Now it's getting a little closer. We need to know, okay, if you haven't made the plan a couple months out, how can you still be prepared, you know, when the storm's approaching?
Well, my first tip is going to be listen to the local media. The TV station, the radio station from this area. That will get you a good start on what it is. We talk about a hurricane watch, which is 36 hours out, 24 to 36 hours out. That's when you really should be getting everything in your home prepared for this storm. We want you to get your shutters, make sure they work. If you're going to use plywood, start putting them up because it's a long, hard project, especially on a warm day. We want you to make a decision. Are you going to stay at home? Are you going to evacuate? And if so, where? Or are you going to go to a Red Cross shelter? Those are all the important questions that you have to answer. Nobody else can answer for
you. And if you haven't made plans to do one of those three things yet, you've experienced many hurricane and other disasters. What do you suggest? It's 36 hours out. I haven't made, you know, plans to go to a shelter, or maybe I'm not in a shelter area. I haven't, my family might be in the path of the storm too if they're in anywhere in Florida. Right. What should I do?
If you're not going to get on a plane and go a distance away, stay in your home. Then it becomes, is your home old or is it up to code? If it's up to code, stay in it. If it's not, then consider going to a Red Cross shelter, because you'll be safe and you'll be dry. And you'll be well fed, but I don't guarantee you being comfortable.
But safe and dry are the main things.
Yes.
Safe,
yes,
and dry. Well, I want to get to the kit because I don't want to run out of time. You always have good tips on what to put in a kit. Some of them are obvious, a flashlight, but not so obvious, some of them.
Right. How about dog food for your pet?
That's my favorite one, because you worry about
That's
the baby,
right,
the teenagers, your husband, your wife, but you forget about the dog or cat.
And how about things for your elderly parents that might be living with you? Maybe one of them needs a sanitary product. Maybe you should go out and get something for them.
Or ensure, you
or
know,
ensure,
the protein.
Right.
A lot of elderly are on the protein drinks.
Those are the important things.
Okay.
It's very important to have a radio.
I love those crank radios.
This radio cranks. You don't need batteries in it. If you don't have a crank radio, make sure you have plenty of batteries, both for your radio, your maybe even your little portable TV and your flashlights.
And tune it to WXEL FM. Let me put
Without
it in a plug, because we have hurricane coverage from our partners at WPTV and the Sun Sentinel. And I like the crank radios because the kids really get into it. It kind of keeps them entertained for a while. At least it did in Wilma for me.
It's something that
something
they
different.
Can do.
Something
no, it's
different.
Something that they can contribute to it. And another thing is to make plans for your pet. Are you going to have your pet with you? Are you going to put your pet in a vet? Are you going to put him somewhere? There's only one animal shelter in Palm Beach County.
And it's full, from what I understand. People make reservations months out.
Yes, you must have a reservation before you do it. Then I want you to assemble your food that you've been collecting all spring, the little tuna fish cans, and whatever it is that you want to rely on for your 3 days of food, make sure that they're there. Make sure you have the bottled water that's fresh.
And the bottled water is important because, you know, it always seems that when a storm's coming, people just rush and grab it and grab it and grab it. And you can grab a few bottles every time you go to the store, and it could be right there in your garage or in your cupboard.
That's right. And it's not a big expense that
Correct.
Way.
Correct. You're not spending $10, $20 on
At
it
a
all
time,
of a sudden.
Right. So do the same thing with food, tuna fish or peanut butter or something like that. Another thing to check on is what time are your kids going to get out of school? Are they going to be dismissed at the regular time? Are they going to be dismissed early? You have to make plans for that. Same thing with work. You have to know what time the business is closing down. I want you to make a communication plan with an out-of-town friend or relative. You call them and say, I'm staying in my home, or I'm going to the shelter. And let everybody else in your family call them out of town.
I love that idea, because you're too busy to call everyone. Well, there's a lot of other tips. We're going to put some on our website, WXEL.org, as well as the Red Cross. One final note, if you want somebody to come speak and you're of Spanish speaking, they have Spanish speaking experts like Steve. They also have Spanish literature that you can get from Red Cross.
Correct.
Thank you so much. Not to be rude, I hope we don't have to see you again. But if we do, that means the storm's here. Good luck.
Tony, thank you.
Well, we talked about getting your home ready, your family ready, but what about your business? Well, a Boca Raton-based business is way ahead of the game when it comes to that. We took a tour to find out just how to stay prepared.
Once we're 48 hours or so ahead of a potential hurricane threat, we begin the building preparations. And that's essentially making sure that we do all the things that are necessary to reduce the threat to the building. A lot of it is the types of things that you would do in your own home, like examining the outdoors and ensuring that all the loose items that could become projectiles during high winds are brought inside the building. This is one area of the building that we needed to further protect because the normal windows that we have here as part of the entry to the building are not impact glass. We are in NCCI's atrium at the moment, and this area that you see behind me is really the reason why we needed to find some new form of application, some new form of technology to protect the glass that is not impact glass in the building. And this is what you see behind me is almost a three-story tall, what is called a storefront window. And even though it is designed to fare well in high winds, we had the experience of Wilma, and even though we had no major issues, we did see enough of a push in the structure that we decided to look for some additional means of protection against high winds. Well, once the authorities declare a hurricane warning, at that point we stop the operations at NCCI. Employees go home at that time to make sure that they can make the final preparations at home and ensure that they have their families protected. But at that point, really, the building's taken over by a small dedicated group of NCCI employees that will be at the building not only before the hurricane, during, and even after, ensuring that the building is well protected and that we can bring back the operations of NCCI as soon as possible after the hurricane threat has passed. We're lucky here at NCCI that we have an in-house cafeteria, so obviously we have enough food for this small group of employees to get by during the hurricane. You also see here just your basic necessities, flashlights, bedding materials, cots, towels, in the event that we're here for many days. We believe that to have a successful hurricane preparation plan, not only do you need to prepare beforehand, but you need to be prepared for anything that, any situation that you could face during the hurricane and immediately after where resources are not gonna be clearly available. So rather than have to wait for glass and for somebody to come and repair it after the fact, we've prepared through the use of this plexiglass that's been specifically cut out for these windows that are all standardized. We've prepared these standby pieces so that in the event that we do have a breaking of a window, we can mitigate the water and the wind coming into the facility by using the plexiglass as protection. After the hurricane, days after, then we can worry about replacing it with actual glass. What you are seeing here is the most important part of our hurricane preparation plan. In the event that we were to lose power during the hurricane, which is often the case, we have three 800 kilowatt generators that are going to support the building and provide power not only to our data center, which has to remain operational 24/7, but also to the rest of the building, especially when after the hurricane, it's time to resume operations of NCCI and the power may not have been restored as of yet by FPNL. These generators are sufficient to provide power to the entire building, not only the lights, but also air conditioning at a reduced level. So one of the things we typically do after a hurricane is ask the employees to come in casual dress because the building may be a little bit warmer than it's normally the case. But with these generators, we can operate the building both during a hurricane and after.